knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we introduced the cartilaginous fish in terms of their form and function. Now let's go over their diversity and spend some time summarizing each of their orders. As we mentioned, class Chondrichthyes is split between the subclasses Elasmobranchii and Holocephali. Though there are 12 orders of subclass Elasmobranchii, there is only one extant order of Holocephali, Chimeriformes, so let's start there. Members of order Chimeriformes are commonly known as ratfish or ghost sharks. They were once quite common in the world's oceans. Though they are considered to be cartilaginous fish, their last common ancestor with all other members of Chondrichthyes lived about 400 million years ago. Chimeras have a distinctive appearance, with a long tapering tail and elongated snout. They have large plate-like scales, a single gill opening on each side of their body, and are found in temperate and cold waters around the world, at depths ranging from 200 meters down to 2,600 meters. They are slow-moving and feed on a variety of prey, including fish, crustaceans, and mollusks. Elasmobranchii is split into three superorders, Galeomorphii, Squalomorphii, and Batoidea, and each of these superorders contains four orders. Batoidea includes the skates and rays of orders Myliobatiformes, Rhinopristiformes, Ragiformes, and Torpediniformes. They are the largest superorder of cartilaginous fish, with over 600 species, and are easily distinguished by their dorsoventrally flattened bodies, enlarged pectoral fins that are fused to the head, and ventral gill slits. Members of order Myliobatiformes are often collectively called stingrays, and include over 220 species, which include the American round stingrays, whiptail stingrays, eagle rays, manta rays, devil rays, thornbacks, deep water stingrays, freshwater stingrays, butterfly rays, and others. They are typically characterized by their flattened bodies and enlarged pectoral fins that extend outwards to form a wide disc-like shape. They also lack a dorsal fin and instead have a long whip-like tail that may contain one or more venomous spines for defense. Though they are not aggressive and generally flee when disturbed, when attacked by predators or stepped on by humans, they do occasionally whip their tail, inflicting a painful and very occasionally fatal sting. Since their clade is diverse, they are found in a range of marine habitats worldwide, from shallow coastal waters to deep oceanic trenches. They are known to feed on a variety of prey, including crustaceans, fish, and mollusks, and play important ecological roles in their respective ecosystems. Order Ragiformes once included all members of Myliobatiformes as well, but more recent phylogenetic analyses have confirmed their divergence. They include about 10 species of smooth skates and more than 150 true skates, which are characterized by their flat body shape with flat pectoral fins that extend the length of their body. The skates are unique among the rays in that they produce their young in an egg case called a mermaid's purse. These egg cases have distinct characteristics that are individualized to each species. Though the skates of family Ragidae look similar to rays, all skates reproduce using eggs, while rays are primarily viviparous, meaning they give birth to live young. Skates lack a whip-like tail and stinging spines, and their morphologies are different. Some, like the spotted rays, are able to produce electricity from their electric organ located in their tail. Meanwhile, order Rhinopristiformes includes the sawfish, guitarfish, giant guitarfish, wedgefish, and banjo rays. They are characterized by their unique snouts that are either elongated and saw-like in the case of sawfish, or flattened and broad in the case of guitarfish. Rhinopristiformes are found in tropical and subtropical waters worldwide, in both marine and freshwater habitats. They are primarily benthic, and many species are in sharp decline due to overfishing for their fins. Finally, order Torpediniformes includes the electric rays. These are slow-moving bottom dwellers, characterized by their disc-shaped body and their ability to produce electric shocks as both a feeding and defense mechanism. Their electric organs are located on either side of their head and are used for defense and hunting. Next up, the superorder Galeomorphii includes the Galeon sharks of orders Carcharhiniformes, Heterodontiformes, Lamniformes, and Orectolobiformes. They are often referred to as modern sharks, and they include most of the well-known shark species, except for the dogfish shark. Members of the order Carcharhiniformes are commonly referred to as ground sharks and are characterized by the presence of a nictitating membrane over the eye, two dorsal fins, an anal fin, and five gill slits. They are the largest order of shark with over 270 species that are found worldwide, where they occupy a diverse array of habitats from shallow estuaries to deep sea trenches. They include the hammerheads, cat sharks, barbelled sharks, weasel sharks, and sandbar sharks, such as the bull shark, which is one species that is often in conflict with humans due to their habitats of shallow coastal waters and territorial nature. Meanwhile, order Heterodontiformes includes a single family of bullhead sharks, all of which are in the same genus. Most of them are relatively small bottom feeders in tropical and subtropical waters. They are morphologically distinct, and many, such as the Port Jackson shark, are noted for the position and morphology of their mouths that contain crushing plates, which are adapted to feed on mollusks, crustaceans, and sea urchins. The Lamniformes are commonly known as mackerel sharks and include perhaps the most famous of all shark species, the great white shark, along with some considerably lesser known species such as the megamouth shark and goblin shark. They also include the thresher sharks, basking sharks, sand sharks, and crocodile sharks. They are differentiated from the other shark orders due to their absence of a nictitating membrane, two dorsal fins, an anal fin, five gill slits, and a mouth that extends behind the eyes. Many species are noted for their great speed, durability, large gill openings, heavy weight, and preference for colder waters. Finally, the members of order Orectolobiformes are commonly known as carpet sharks, or wobbegongs. They are characterized by their flattened bodies, broad heads, and small eyes located towards the top of the head. Most species of carpet sharks are relatively small, but this order also includes the largest species of cartilaginous fish, the whale shark. It also includes the bamboo sharks, blind sharks, nurse sharks, and zebra sharks, which lose their namesake zebra-like coloration as adults. Next, superorder Squalomorphii includes the Squalia or Squalian sharks of orders Hexanchiformes, Pristiophoriformes, Squaliformes, and Squatiniformes. They are characterized by their lack of an anal fin, nictitating membrane, and are often considered to be more ancestral in form than the Galeon sharks. Members of order Hexanchiformes are often considered to be the most primitive sharks and include just seven extant species of cow sharks and frilled sharks. Their morphology is split between the large, stocky cow sharks and the thin and slender frilled sharks, which are noted for their unique dentition. Several species are considered to be living fossils that inhabit the deep ocean. Pristiophoriformes, likewise, is also a small order with just a few extant species, known as saw sharks. They are noted for their saw-like rostrum that is edged with sharp teeth that they use to slash at their prey. They are most common in the Indian and Southern Pacific Ocean. In contrast with these smaller orders, Squaliformes is the largest order of Squalian sharks, containing the dogfish sharks and their relatives. They are extremely variable in size and shape, though all species lack anal fins and nictitating membranes. They include the only cartilaginous fish capable of producing bioluminescence, such as the lantern sharks and the sleeper sharks, some of which, like the velvet dogfish, have luminous organs and therefore exhibit intrinsic bioluminescence. Other sleeper sharks include the Greenland shark, or gray shark, which has the longest known lifespan of all vertebrate species, the oldest species of which is estimated to be between 250 and 500 years. Finally, order Squatiniformes includes a single family and a single genus of angel sharks. They have flattened bodies, large pectoral fins, and camouflaged coloration that allows them to blend in with their environment. They are primarily bottom-dwelling predators, feeding on a variety of fish and invertebrates. Once they were considered common, but many species are now listed as critically endangered since they are particularly sensitive to bottom trawling and are often caught in gill nets. Let's conclude by mentioning that a great deal of cartilaginous fish species may be threatened with extinction, and many non-threatened species are declining. In many areas, cartilaginous fish are still hunted for their fins and flesh, or caught as bycatch, meaning a marine species that is caught unintentionally while fishing for other species, and often killed as a result. Since they are often long-lived and have low fecundity, their populations rebound slowly. Thankfully, there are many charities that support repopulating cartilaginous fish, and many governments are passing stricter laws that limit or entirely restrict hunting sharks for fins. Hopefully, we can work together to recover these essential species rather than aid in their decline. But for now, let's leave the cartilaginous fish and check out their sister clade, the bony fish.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.